Not on the level of conversation, but on the food. So if you call around to somebody and you get a lovely flaming plum pudding, you'll call back again for a visit, definitely. Do you have plum pudding out here?
No.
This is the real treat now around Christmas time. It's very dense, and you boil it for days, really, I suppose. But it's a very dense pudding with currants and raisins and a lot of brandy, usually a lot of Guinness as well. And if you really want to get it flaming like this, you could pour some poutine on it before you light it. Okay, some of you have heard of poutine. Some of you haven't, maybe?
Yes.
Poutine is basically Irish moonshine made from potatoes. And it's rocket fuel. And it's quite hard to get because it's highly illegal. The reason is a lot of people were going blind and drinking too much. So it's illegal, and you have to be very careful about going about getting some poutine now, right, the festive season. We used to get 2 bottles every Christmas from somebody who always had a supply, the parish priest. Because he heard in confession who had poutine, so he'd come around to these houses. He'd demand that they give him this devil juice, and then he'd dish it out to his friends. So just be careful if you're going to light a plum pudding after pouring a drop of poutine on it. Stand back if you value your hair and your eyelashes and all the rest of it, because it's pretty, pretty potent. But that's a big part of it, and I suppose turkey is a very common meal now on Christmas Day in Ireland, but it wasn't long ago the traditional Christmas feast was the goose. There's a nice goose there. Before. And after. And it's absolutely gorgeous, much nicer than turkey, I think. So between all the goose and the plum pudding and all the brandy and all the rest of it, Usually you'd have gout by the 6th of January, but it's well worth it. But that idea of the feasting and of the hospitality is a very important part of Irish life. It always has been. And going back to the time when the Gaelic aristocracy were, I suppose, in charge of the country to a large extent. This is before the Battle of Kinsale in 1607. And after that battle, a lot of the big noble chieftains were forced to leave Ireland. But before that, they were the pillars in Irish life. And musicians and poets would receive fantastic hospitality from these Gaelic chieftains in the houses. And one of the big families around Usheen's part of the country, around the northwest of Ireland, were the O'Rourkes. And their hospitality was famous. When they threw a party, it would go on for days and nights, and there'd just be endless feasting, and there'd be plenty of wine and ale and porter, loads and loads and loads of food. And there's a tune that was composed by one musician who received fantastic hospitality with them. His name was Thurlough O'Carolan, and I suppose he's known as Ireland's national composer because his legacy is just enormous. He composed music in the 17th century, and he was a blind harper, but he travelled around Ireland staying with these wealthy patrons, and he'd stay with them for a couple of weeks, feasting away, and if he was well treated, he'd write a tune in honour of his hosts. So here's one of his tunes. It's called Feasta na Ruarcach, or Cléireacha na Ruarcach, which means the Feast of the O'Rourkes. It goes back to the 17th century. So we're going to hand you over now to our own harper. This is Gráinne Hanley once again from Mayo, and she'll start this one. Thank you.